Our Prime Minister emphasized on tea for tourism. But now what?
When Mr. Modi started talking about tourism as one of the teas, it was such a big thing for us, because never before a Prime Minister of the country has spoken about tourism. And we were expecting things to change like anything. But thereafter, in actual terms, the Ministry of Tourism stopped working completely. I will go because there is nothing has been achieved in last 2-3 years because of various factors, whether they were in within the control of the ministry or not, that's irrelevant. But end of the day, on the ground, there was nothing being done for the tourism sector. We have taken up all the complete detailed points in covering about 7-8 pages. We made this, we discussed with all concerned, right from Prime Minister's office, Tourism Minister, Commerce Minister, Secretaries Tourism and Commerce Ministry, and Revenue Secretary. We placed before each and every one of them and had detailed discussions. I will not say that they never heard us, they have not discussed with us, they discussed each and every point with us and agreed with us that yes, what you are saying, 90 or 85% things they agreed to. But nothing has moved forward. As a private player, we can do so much. That's all.
The government has to take the change of mindset. Even putting us on the five T's, still not doing anything. Our representations are going on a regular basis. It's the change of mindset. Once the change, and they don't stop considering as elitist. They think that they will just get away with it. But no, it's not the right thing. Unless the mindset becomes positive, nothing will happen.
Yes, when Prime Minister announced the five T's and one of the T was tourism, we were very happy that the country is going to think about tourism. Because I'm in the industry for last 40 years, there is no change. And still, after announcing the five T's, there is no change. And it is very, you know, hard to believe, because we can give our suggestions, because we are bound to work under certain regulations and the guidance and watch of Finance Ministry, and the regulations we have to follow as per the government rules. Unless there are some relaxation on the government rules and some encouragement given to the industry, how industry can flourish? Only a good governance is required to help the industry, and that good governance should come from the government side. So we are doing our part and government has to do their part. In December, they have announced the release of second edition of the e-visa. Till now, it is not implemented. So how you think that tourism is going to grow?
Ticketing was the main business for the travel agent, to be very frank, and they were making the most of their profits from the ticketing business. But from the last so many years, India is one of the most powerful country where airlines who have started with 2 flights a week now running 280 flights a week. It means there is a big business for them. But they are not giving any proper income. There is no fixed income for a travel agent, whether he is approved by IATA or Ministry of Tourism. There is no fixed income. And on their own portal, they are giving 15%, 20% cheaper. And I don't know how they are managing that. So it's a big debate which is going on. But, you know, we are losing on our domestic business also. Earlier, you know, all these luxury hotels, that Raj Vilas or the Uday Vilas, they were 70 or 80% full by the foreign tourists, 20% by Indians. From the last 4 years, it has reversed, 70% full by Indians and 20-30% by foreigners. But now, because of this tax problem, demonetizations, Indians are afraid to enter these luxury hotels, you know, so that's why they are going vacant, to be very frank. In our presentations, we say 75% of Buddha, 80% of Himalayas, but Singapore has one Lord Buddha statue, they get more tourists than us. Thailand has one statue, they get more tourists.
One of the teas that we were very excited about was tourism, but nothing, it was like engagement took place, but the marriage didn't happen. I think it is time now we have to look in a very wider perspective. You asked a question that are we responsible? Let me tell you that all in one sink can tell you that whatever effort we can put, we are putting our level best. We are knocking at the door. But there has to be some listening for it. And then there has to be some delivery about it. We have to now look at tourism collectively. And the dialogue has to happen where the delivery happens. Unless the delivery doesn't happen, it will not take us anywhere. So when I will be touching an outbound where the government is required is when now if they see that if they start taxing the outbound tourism in India, whom are they going to benefit? We have a digital world now, and Indian government is today now in the today's budget also today they have decided to put in a lot of money in the digital world. Can you stop that people can buy hotels from overseas or through their friends and families and not pay taxes and they pay from BTQ? That is our way of, that's a process that we have set up. But by putting that tax and killing that industry, we are actually bringing down the revenue as well as the investment which is coming and employment in a big way.
With this, our budget episode comes to a close.